Parker, and today I'm going to teach you guys how to handle a breakaway. This, it's a simple shot in practice, just like the penalty, but in game there's a lot of pressure. And the reason I think there's a lot of pressure is in a game there's 22 people sharing it almost even. Now, even though there's still 22 people actively on the field, it's just you and the goalie, or if you're the goalie and the attacker. Kind of narrows down who the pressure's on, and because it's such a simple shot, it puts a lot of pressure on the attacker to score. So I'm going to talk about the goalie, how to handle it if you're the goalie, and how to handle it with the attacker. But because this is under the shooting videos, I'm going to spend more time on the attacker. So when you're the goalie, as most goalies should know, you never stand on your line. Standing on this puts you as a sitting duck. There's so much extra space. You're going to want to stand about here, and depending on where the attacker is, you're going to want to charge. Now, one mistake I've seen goalies do, even professional goalies, I saw Diego Lopez do this. He charged when the attacker had a defender on him. You shouldn't charge like that, because then you're just getting off your line. Only charge when it's just the attacker or when he's beating the defense. If he still has a defender on him, stay relatively close to your goal. Don't go all the way out here and let the attacker chip it over you and let Barcelona win the El Clasico. Don't let that happen. So what we're going to do here is Gerbreed's going to come at me, and I will show you how to handle it. He still will most likely score. Goalies, unfortunately, don't have much of a chance on these. They just hope for a spectacular save on their part or a bad shot on the shooters. So, let's see it. All right, he's coming towards me. I'm going to go out. I'm going to go down. And I had him for the most part. I'm not a goalie, so he did score. A normal goalie would have dived. I'm sorry, but I'm a midfielder. Alright. So now I'll actually show you on the other part. So, there are three types of ways to handle a breakaway when you're on the attack. First is a simple shot. You can add fakes. I've seen Kaka step to the side and go to one side. You can add fakes, but it's just down to the basics of the shot. The second one is a chip, which I'll have another video explaining in-depth chipping. And the last one is rounding the goalie. So I'm going to give you some examples of each of these so you can see them.
Nice. Yeah, don't let Barcelona win, huh?
Alright, here we go.
Don't stop Barcelona. Look at that.
Alright, so this is going to be a simple shot.
A simple shot.
Alright, that one, I did what Ricardo Kaka, or more, aka Kaka, does a lot. He stepped away from the ball, making it look like he was going to curl it to his near post, but he just taps it to the side. When the goalie sees the player back off, he thinks, all right, he's going to go this way, but then he just taps it the other way. You don't need to do that, but it's an option. So another example, this one will come from the right wing. So on that example, the goalie didn't challenge me hard enough. I got close enough to the goal, and I just hit it. Because when you're that close to the goalie, even if the goalie gets a hand to it, it's not going to be strong enough to keep it out. So now, here's some examples of a chip. Alright. So, when you're doing these in practice, take one, think about any mistakes you made. I looked at that one, I saw the goalie didn't challenge me as hard as it should have, so I chipped it anyway, shouldn't have done that. You gotta read and react, and that's a good example where even if you're thinking, chip, 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 you still hit a normal shot because the chip's not gonna work there. There, I let the ball come close to me. I was dribbling and I let the ball come really close to my foot and I just chipped it over. It's easier to chip the ball when it's closer to your foot than when it's out here and you gotta chip it. Those are just some key points. So this last example is gonna be rounding the goalie. This is a really flashy example. If you guys don't know what this is, it's basically where the goalie comes out and either you fake the shot and then you go around him, or the goalie comes and you just take that quick touch to the side. So I'm gonna show you three examples from this, one from each side. You guys can decide whether or not this is something you wanna do. It's not something I prefer to do. So, here.